even though he's only 5'5", Manny Gamburian is one of the most badass UFC fighters out there. We caught up with him.
Yeah, I'm fighting June 26th in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, Tyson Griffin. It's a tough fight, you know, he's a gamer, so I got to step up my game plan, you know. I got to stick with my game plan, you know, do what I do best and go out there and put on a show and probably get a knockout or submission.
You know what's crazy, though? When people picture an MMA fighter, they think of a guy like Shaquille O'Neal, like 7'5", 690.
I'm only 5'5", so...
You're a badass at 5'5". You knock people out. Tell me about that. Are people surprised sometimes? Now you're famous, but before you made it, when you told them, oh, I'm a fighter.
Well, it all started from the Ultimate Fighter Show, Top 5 when I was there. You know, everybody was like 6 feet, 5'10", 5'11", 6'4", sometimes, you know? I was like, what am I doing here? And even the promoter said, Manny, you don't think you're too small for this weight class? I'm like... You know, big things come in small packages, so we'll see. I'm going to go out there and leave everything in the cage, and that's what I did. And, you know, unfortunately, I lost within Nate Diaz on the finals, but it is what it is. Everything happens for a reason.
He didn't lose, I think. And Manny popped out a shoulder, but he won 3 fights, and then he was in the finals. So he was winning the first round, and got his shoulder hurt when he went for a takedown. So Manny could do that in 155. Now he's down to 145. You know, he's stronger.
Manny, speaking of Nick Diaz, he's thinking of quitting MMA and becoming a pro boxer. What do you say about that?
I mean, Nick is very talented. Don't get me wrong. I mean, the both brothers, you know, they're very talented. They're good, very good fighters. I mean, Nick, I mean, he's a brawler. He's a fighter. He can fight MMA and boxing, but boxing is a different game. So I don't know. I don't know if he can do it. And he's calling out big names. I mean, I don't know. He's Nick Diaz, so he's doing pretty good. So I wish him nothing but the best. I mean, he's going to do boxing. I mean, good luck with that.
Edmund, do you think this is the future? MMA guys becoming boxers, boxing becoming MMA fighters?
Yeah, I think it helps out the gyms, you know. A lot of kids come in and they like MMA, and a lot of them like boxing, you know. I think it's going to start converting and they're going to go to do whatever they want to. And I think people that like to strike, they'll keep on striking and boxing. People that like to grapple, they'll go into MMA.
Right here, your gym, what's more popular?
We have a lot of karate programs for kids and judo programs for kids, so I think more popular is MMA. But, you know, but in the mornings, it's all the pro boxers, and that's why I get Manny and all the good MMA fighters come by me so they can learn boxing. So I try to keep it from morning until 4 p.m. hits, you know, for boxing. And then after 4, the kids' programs. We have amateur boxing programs for kids, and we have a lot of karate and judo and all that stuff. So it's half and half, I would say.
Right here, 601 South Brand in Glendale. What's the name?
Glendale Fighting Club.
That's it. People come here to fight. Don't fight in the streets.
Fight in the gym.
FiusNewsReporting.com from the Glendale Fighting Club in Glendale. I'm Ellie Steckback reporting.